Model building in Flux is designed to be simple and intuitive. Let's go over the main aspects of most deep learning models. We start by creating a dense layer with a single input and output. Like many deep learning frameworks, Flux automatically sets a random weight value for the layers we created. In deep learning, weights and biases are two of many fine-tuning knobs that help us get our model to learn something of value. While one layer is a helpful example to get started with, the real power in deep learning comes when we stack up layers on top of one another. Flux provides a chain function which allows us to connect multiple layers together so they are called in sequence. Another way to think about models in Flux is as predictive functions, where we take some input, make a prediction, and provide an output. Next, let's create a convolutional layer which will help our model do more complicated deep learning tasks. One of the challenges with using flat layers, like a dense layer, is that the information around each pixel is lost in the learning process. This is why convolutional layers are so important for learning features in deep learning. So let's create a convolutional layer. The first part of the convolutional layer is the filter. Here it is set to 5x5. In deep learning for computer vision, 5x5 specifies the number of pixels that the layer should be looking at as it filters through an image. After the filter, we set the input and output channel sizes. Again, just like the filter, the input and output channel sizes depend on the specific data we're working with. In this case, we have 3 input channels and 7 output channels. Last, we can specify the activation function. Here, we'll use the ReLU activation function. Activation functions act as transformations that help tailor the model to our needs. Let's create some fake input data and pass it to our convolutional layer. Here, we've essentially created 50 three-channel images with random float values associated with them. We can then pass these values into our convolutional layer and look at what the output is. Convolutional layers traditionally work in conjunction with other dense layers, linear layers, and many other types of layers provided by the Flux.jl package. These layers in conjunction allow us to emulate what some may consider to be a close representation of the function of the brain. You can learn more about all the provided model types and layer types in the Flux.jl documentation.